I forget. Okay, now it's recording. Okay, and then the next word we should know the sarf is alladhi is isam mausul, b harf of jar, yadi is hand, yadun, yadan, yadin, yadani, yadaini, yadaini, yaduna. No, we don't have more than two hands. Maybe yeah. Plural, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, we can. Yaduna, yadina, yadina. And the broken plural will be
yadan.
Aidin. Aidin, right? The broken plural of yadin is aidin.
Okay.
So this is yadi because it's jar version.
Yeah.
Bi anna ba harf ful jar.
Yeah.
Al mulku, like Ustaz said, it is from Malaka Yamliku. Maraba family.
Which family?
Maraba Malaka Yamliku.
Dorma.
Ya, Maraba Yamliku, Malaka Yamliku, Mulkan Fahuwa Malikun. Mulika Yumlaku, Mulkan Fahuwa Mamlukun. Al-Amru Minhu Imlik, Wan-Nahyu Anhu La Tamlik, Wa-Gharfu Minhu Mamlakun, Mamlikun Wa Mamlakatun. So, Al-Mulku is a Masdar. Mulkan, Mulkun, Mulkan, Mulkin. So, Mulkun, we have Al, so it become al-mulku.
Ooh.
We can check again.
This is great, Hannah. Thank you. Yeah, to do this. Yeah.
Because
surf is not easy to remember.
Yeah, yeah. We inshallah, if we do often, we will remember. Zik, tolong di. Ya, keluar dulu. Malaka. Ya, yeah, like Ustaz said, this is I. Malaka, Yamliku. Tolong buka pintu luar. Bawah. Malaka, Yamliku. Oke.
Okay. Ana, what it means, I means?
Ya.
Yeah, what so, it indicates?
Ya, yeah, so I we have in a small family like Nasara Yansuru and
okay.
Yansuru we had U Fataha Yaptahu A Maraba Yadribu I.
Like so, this I is indicator for small families, right?
Yeah, yeah. So okay. It said I for Yadribu Maraba Yadribu Malaka Yamliku. Yeah, that's I.
So the okay. E is for the mudori, yeah. The E is the
yeah.
The clue yeah. For the mudori.
Yeah, and here is the masdar. Malkan, mulkan, milkan. But what we have here in the ayah is mulkan. Okay. For the rest, I don't know the meaning. Ha. Something ha on or then we didn't learn this yet.
No, but we don't need to know. Yeah, we as long as we know madi, mudori, and master, yeah. That's good.
I think we good with this. And then after mulkan, al mulku wa harf on top, huwa independent pronoun ala harf of jar kulli special mudaf. Shay'in is ism, what to say, jamid. It doesn't have sarf. And here is qadir. It is ism sifa.
Shay'in mudaf ilayh?
Which one?
Shay'in. Shay'in is mudaf ilayh?
Yeah, shay'in is mudaf ilayh. But in a vocabulary wise, this is jamid. We don't do sarf. For oh. Shay'in.
Okay.
Yeah. It's not belongs to any family.
And okay. It's verb? Ism.
Ism, because it's mudaf ilayh, always ism,
yeah,
right?
It's ism, right. And we don't have its arab, like shayun, shayyan, shayin. We don't have.
Oh,
or
we can do. We can do. Jamid means doesn't belong to any family, but we can still do arab, like you said, shayun, shayan, shayin. Shayani, shayaini, shayaini. We still do that.
What do you call it? Called jamid? I forgot.
Yeah, jamid. Yeah.
It's the same thing like the word
but
Allah.
Ism, how we can say that it has no belong with the families? Ism does not belong with families, right?
No, I mean, like, mulku. Al-mulku is ism, but it belongs to family. When a word has nothing to do with any action, like here, shay'in, thing. You don't do thing.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
But dominion, like a kingdom, you know, we can do like, you know. Qadirun. Is ism sifa and based on hanswer vocabulary. Let's see. Qadara. Okay, so here, it's possible that it come from. U, you is for Nasara. Nasara yansuru, Qadara yakduru. Or from Baraba family. Baraba yadribu, Qadara yakdiru. This is Masdar, Qadran.
Okay. Qadra yaqdiru qadran fahuwa qadir.
Yeah. And then more specifically he said here qadara yaqdiru in the Naraba family meaning to possess strength, power or ability. This one that we have in ayah number one to have power or strength or ability, right? In Nasara family, if you put Qadara in Nasara family, it means to decree, to ordain, or to decide. So it has several meaning. Competent. So competent is have ability, right? That's why it's more... I think it's come from Baraba family. Ability. Okay.
That's good.
And
yeah.
Agree?
Yeah, that's fine. I think that's STH is something.
Yeah, you are right. And when we have something like this, it said that this word is muta'addi. It can take maaf on bihi something. So you can do the second line. Okay, here to have power. Qadara yaqdiru quduran wa maqduratan. Okay, here the masdar. Makduran, kudran, makduran. Here I find I got the masdar. Okay. Yeah, kudratan wa makduratan fahuwa qadirun. Kudira yuk daru kudratan wa makduratan fahuwa makdurun. Al-amru minhu iqdir, wal-nahyu anulha taqdir, wal-zarfu minhu maqdarun, maqdirun wa maqdaratun, was-sifatu qadirun. So, oh yeah, here. I should make it extensive.
Maqdarun.
Qadirun. Qadiran, qadirin. So we use this one.
So you have three meaning, yeah, to have power, ability, or capability. Yeah.
Yeah. But that, let's take only one. Yeah, we can take here and whenever you want. Okay.
That's why translation is not easy, because in English you can use other ways of saying, but in Arabic we just choose one.
Okay. So it says to possess, not to have, to possess. Okay, that's all. Sarf, the word we should know, the sarf. Tabaraka, al-mulku, hadir. The rest, I just put here in this table. Alladhi is ism mausul ba harf of jar. Yadi is hand, feminine because Arab said so, and it's fully flexible. Damir mutasil, yeah, you can check by yourself. And come back to the grammar again. We should do this carefully this time, inshallah. Tabaraka, we agree it is fi'il that come from tafa'ala family. Actually, I have something here. Maybe I can find. Someone sent me this implication of sarf families. Tafa'ala, I think. If I like 444. Family 5, 666, family 6. Ah, okay, tafa'ula. So, action involving more than one person, both of them working. It's pretending. New meaning, gradualism. No. I don't think here. So, tafa'ala family is actually tabaraka is lazim, and it affects the doer himself. It's not affecting another one. So, tabaraka, to be blessed, it's not that he is blessing someone here. The meaning is blessed is himself. So, yeah. And we agree, alladhi biyadihi al-mulku wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. The whole fragment, the whole, from here to here is a mausul and silatul mausul, and it is a fragment. Even though we have two jumla ismiyas here, which is a sentence, which is two sentences, but because we have alladhi, it turned into a fragment, and this fragment take a role as a fa'il of tabaraka. So we change huwa to this. Tabaraka means blessed is he. And we change he to alladhi biyadihil mulku wa huwa ala kulli shay'in qadir. Blessed is he in whose hand al-mulk, and he has power over everything. What to say? Yeah. And then someone said that allazi can be mubtada, therefore al mulku is khabar. I would say it's not like that, because allazi is not independent. It always come with silatul mausul, and it's never become a part of the silatul mausul. So if you say mubtada, allazi is mubtada, it become part of silatul mausul. It cannot be. And the job of allazi of isim mausul is to turn a sentence into a fragment. If this is belong to the sentence, then who's turn the sentence into a fragment? Who will do that, right?
Isim mausul.
Yeah, that's why I said isim mausul cannot be part of this jumlah. That's why if you say mubtada, that's mean allazi is part of the jumlah, right?
Right.
It cannot be because it's a mausul, and silatul mausul is different.
Oh,
but,
yes, that's
but,
right.
But they are connected with each other.
Yeah, they are connected because the isim mausul, the allazi make the silatul mausul,
yeah,
this is a sentence into a fragment. So yeah, that's why you cannot say this is mubtada.
Okay. Okay. So al mulku is mubtada?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah. This is the first rafa in these sentences. You have to see this as one. You cannot see the whole thing as one. No. In the micro analysis, you have to look at this as one sentence.
Okay.
Therefore, you cannot make this mubtada for here. Okay. And then, because you have alladhi, this sentence become a fragment.
Yep.
No longer sentence. Yeah. That's why al-mulku is mubtada. We don't have khabar here.
Okay.
The second possibility is that waw is create a new sentence. So the fa'il will end at mulku. Alladhi biyadihil mulku. This is the fa'il. This is the second option, right? So, and this jumlah, completely new sentence, has nothing to do with a previous sentence. So
yeah, because it's a complete sentence. Yeah, the second one is a complete sentence.
Yeah, in the first one we have the whole ayah as one jumlah fi'liyah, one jumlah fi'liyah, and in the second option we have two sentences. First is jumlah fi'liyah, tabaraka alladhi biyadihil mulku, tabaraka is fi'il, and alladhi biyadihil mulku is fa'il. So this is the jumlah fi'liyah. And the second sentence is jumlah ismiyah, wa huwa ala kulli syai'in qadir. Okay. Huwa is mubtada, ala kulli syai'in qadir, fall into one bucket, jar wa majrur, therefore it is muta'alliq bil khabar. It's not muqaddam. Oh yeah, this is muqaddam because qadir is khabar muakhar. It should be wa huwa qadirun ala kulli shay'in. That's the normal order.
After yesterday we said it is common, so it is not. If it is common, it is not muqaddam.
Yeah.
No, it is muqaddam, but not ikhtisas.
Yeah, you can say both. You can say it's there is no ikhtisas, and you can say also this is not muqaddam because if you have a khabar as a common ism, this is a normal order. Yeah, you're right. This is normal order. Like here we have muta'alliq bil khabar muqaddam and the mubtada is ma'rifah proper. Here we have ikhtisas. That's why I make here.
Should we not write here? We will not write here muqaddam. It's okay. The translation is not ikhtisas, but we will not write muqaddam. Is it okay?
Yeah, it's okay because it's say. When the khabar is common, the normal order is the muta'alliq bil khabar will come first.
Okay.
And here we have ikhtisas. Muta'alliq bil khabar muqaddam yadullu ala al-ikhtisas. So, in this case, ikhtisas, but not only ikhtisas. We can have ikhtimar, and something else. The thing that I want to add tonight is that, remember about jumlah haliyah. It seems like a jumlah haliyah. Wa huwa ala kulli syai'in qadir. If you want to review about jumlah haliyah, let's see if I have something. What do you think if wa huwa ala kulli syai'in qadir? If I say wa huwa ala kulli syai'in qadir is a jumlah haliyah.
I forgot what the definition of jumlah haliyah.
Condition. It's a condition.
What is jumlah haliyah here?
So let's see. Jumlah haliyah can be translated as an adverb or an ing or the word while or as. So in the ayah wa huwa ala kulli syai'in qadir, it appears as a jumlah ismiyah. It started with waw and directly jumlah haliyah, simple jumlah haliyah. So we have here waw and directly simple jumlah ismiyah.
Okay, if waw followed by simple jumla ismiyah, it's jumla haliyah, right?
It could be. Yeah. So what I want to say is that there is possibility that wa huwa ala kulli syai'in qadir is the jumla haliyah.
Okay.
That's what I want to add tonight. And this is will affect the translation.
Yeah, the translation will change. That's right, and also
But maybe almost done here. Possible translation will be blessed is the one who in whose hand only. We forgot to add only because we have ikhtisas here. Last night we didn't add only, so I don't know.
Maybe it's not only, maybe especially.
Oh, especially.
Mm-hmm. Because it is, blessed is the one in whose hand.
Like, only in his hand. It's okay to say especially.
Oh, yeah,
okay.
Only is better. Yeah, sorry. Yeah, I thought especially the kingdom, but it's not the kingdom. Yeah. It is, okay.
No one only else. Yeah, only he in. Is this okay? Good order? In English, all the kingdom is only in his hand.
That's fine. You can put only anywhere. So in this one, it is in his hand. Yeah?
Okay. So we should put only here, but not in here. So blessed is the one in whose hand only all the kingdom is. And he if we just thinking this is a new sentence, just and he has power or authority over everything. That's all. But if we thinking this is a jumlah haliyah, blessed is the one in whose hand only all the kingdom is, while he has power or authority over everything, while and. I think in English, it doesn't make any difference when you say and while in this case.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the same meaning.
The same meaning. Because,
mm-hmm. Yeah. We just try to more aware of the grammar, right? Yeah, that's all for ayah number one. Anyone want to
is
add?
Is it all the kingdom? All the kingdom or just kingdom? Why do you put the word all in it?
The kingdom? The kingdom?
Yeah.
Why all?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Here.
Like this?
Here, all the kingdom. Al-Mulku.
Yeah.
Under Al-Mulku.
All? We put all like this? Or
no? No. Yeah, go up in Al-Mulku, word Al-Mulku. Mm-hmm. In yeah, this cell. Yeah. You wrote all. Why not the kingdom?
This is based on yesterday's discussion. Okay. Because honestly, my English is not good, so that's why I really just follow our discussion.
Yeah, you're doing a great job in English.
You are Hannah. Doing very good, Hannah. But it is, as Ustad was saying, translation is not easy. Yeah. Even if you know the language, because you can change anything around. I mean, like this one, we can change it again. Blessed is the one in whose hand only is the kingdom. We can put the is before that. Why at the end? You know, you can play around with that.
Mm-hmm. So, but this is okay?
Blessed
is the one in whose hand
only is the kingdom, right?
Only is the kingdom, like this?
Yeah.
Blessed is the one in whose hand only is the kingdom.
Okay.
It's better not to put is at the end of the word. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Only is. Okay. Okay. Good. Need to add anything for ayah number one?
Very good. I think we can scratch it. Now we can do ayah number two steps very easy after this.
Yeah, inshallah. Okay, so it will end in a few minutes, but meanwhile, we can start ayah number two. Anyone who want to take turn to lead ayah number two? Me?
It seems pretty straightforward and easy.
Yeah, I think the challenge is from here.
Yeah, it is easier.
To here. Yeah. So let's try.
الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ الَّذِي He is the one who خَلَقَ He created. What He created? Because it's a huwa version. No outside doer, I think, right? So he created, what he created, al-mauta, it's a fi mahali rafa, nasab.
No, why fi mahali?
Al-mauta is nasab, maful, right? Yeah. Wal-hayata, and life. Khalaq al-mauta is mudaf ilayhi. No.
Khalaqa is a fi'il, it cannot be mudaf.
Right. Khalaqa, he created al-mauta, the death, wal-hayata, and the life. Li yabluwakum. Li so. It's a harf of li.
Harf of light or half of lightest?
No idea.
No, I think Ustad Numan has just give us an example about Li and Li Kai, remember?
Bata ka. Inlan Li Kai dan hata?
Yes. It's, you can use it as the meaning of so that.
So that?
Yeah, so that or maybe, or what is it, three meaning?
Mm-hmm.
You remember he said there are three meaning. So that, oh, what did he say yesterday? Let me check.
Yeah.
So I think it's meaning is so.
The thing is, we have several kind of lam. So yeah, lam yeah. Of jar, lam harf
of
light, you know?
Toki, lam, yeah, lam toki.
Yeah. So how we decided which yeah. lam is this? So yeah. we can see next word.
See, harf this of jar is only with ism. It's not ism, so it's not harf of jar, right?
Yeah, right. So two possibilities. Yeah.
Yeah. Lam taqid and lam like shartiya, what we say? Sorry.
No, it's lam harfun nasibatun mudari. Like harf of light. Harf of light. Remember anlan li kai idan hatta?
Hatta, yeah. Yeah. Li and kai. Li and kai.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, right. So this is harfun nasibah for harf of light or harful jazimah for harf of lightest. So this is harf nasibah. Okay. Make the next fi'il.
Yeah.
So if what? Continue, please.
Yeah. If it is harf of nasibah, if it is not here, then the fi'il should be Yabluwa, what it should be?
Yablu.
Only Yablu?
Yeah, with Alif Maksura.
Oh.
No, with Alif Maksura or what? Let's see, let's check here.
Yeah.
This is Naqis, remember?
Yeah, I think.
Balawa. Balawa. Okay, I think here. Okay, balawa. Bala ya blue. So yeah. Yeah, like
with
ya da'u. Da'a ya da'u du'aan. So yeah, this one. It's the like this. Okay, I think
This is irregular surf, yeah.
Yeah, this is naqis.
Yeah, this is difficult to remember.
Yeah. But,